Hello, I'm Dr. Sudhanshu. I'm DNB consultant physician. Today I'll be discussing on climate change and its repercussions. Climate change refers to any change in climate over time, whether due to natural variability or as a result of human activity. Climate change is caused by power plants, excessive use of power plants, use of non-renewable source in transportation throughout the world, use of non-renewable source as a power in farming, deforestations here and there going on throughout the world without afforestations, use of fertilizers in the farms that degrades the quality of soil, and finally cause the fertile land to become barren and decrease the food yielding capability, oil drilling. And to add one more point, natural gas drilling also causes global warming. So global warming affects so many things, mainly the conflicts and war between countries, the economic consequences that happens because of war and conflict between countries, between continents. And so it causes drought to happen in so many places. So many places faces flood, sudden flash floods, change in the weather, which causes storm to happen. And with all this, so many diseases arises, tropical diseases, vector-borne diseases, diseases that is caused by impure water, impure air, decrease in secured shelter, place for the secured shelter. So these all are the effects of global warming. So to be more concise on health effect of global warming or climate change, it affects our gastrointestinal disease system. People throughout the world face lot of incidences of diarrhea, dehydration, vomiting, acute gastrointestinal diseases. Sometimes that acute gastrointestinal diseases leads to nervous system disease, respiratory problems, liver and kidney failures. And to add in the list, so many people also have to face post-traumatic stress disorder because of consequences of natural disaster, flood, storm, as they lose their family members, their cattle, and that severely impact their normal life. So how can we prevent global warming? How can we change global warming or stop happening of the global warming? First and foremost thing, we should all come up together, speak about global warming. So we should all know that what we are doing and how can we prevent it. Until and unless we don't speak about it, might get very late, rather very delayed, and it might have severe catastrophic consequences in our human health. So we should all try to emphasize the use of renewable sources of energy like hydroelectricity, wind energy, solar energy. We should all try to switch to most energy efficient use of appliances like LED bulbs. Previously conventional bulb was used, but now we are gradually switching to more energy efficient and more sustainable LED bulbs. We have switched from cathode ray television to LCD, LED, and so many other advanced appliances that uses less energy. We should try to reduce water waste. We should try to plant trees, because trees are that plays very important role in preventing the global warming. So we should all have the facility of sustainable transportation habit. The culture, the country, the society, the policy should all favor the use of sustainable transport habits like cycling, battery driven transport, so that the global warming and carbon dioxide emission is as low as possible. We should always try to have construction that is more eco-friendly, that is more greenhouse friendly, and that reduces the electricity bill. So these are the few basic things that we can do to prevent the global warming and overall climate change in our planet. So to be very concise, it's in everybody's hand that we can prevent this planet and make it more sustainable, livable place for our coming generation. So the best thing that we can do is to give a livable place for our upcoming generation so that they become more happy and lead a happier life in this planet. Thank you so much.